February 1st is the feast day of the martyrs of Angers. Two daughters of charity who were martyred during the French war on 1st February 1794. Sister Mary Ann was born in France on 13 May 1734 and entered the company of the Daughters of Charity on 25th September 1761. Sister Odile was born at Lorraine, France on 15th November 1750 and entered the company of the Daughters of Charity on 4th August 1775. By September 1792, the hospital sisters in Angers saw a rise in religious persecution following their bishop. Numerous priests refused to take the required oath. Driven from their parishes, they were quickly arrested. A year later, 400 of them were put in chains and taken through the city of Angers to prison. The sisters were saying to the companions nearest them, "A crown is destined for us. Let us not lose it today. Just a little more effort and victory is ours." Blessed Odile, aged 43, and Blessed Mary Ann Violet, aged 60, were two of the three religious sisters and were martyred on 1st February 1794. They were from the hospital of St. John in Angers and were Daughters of Charity of the congregation founded by St. Vincent de Paul and St. Louis de Marillac. The execution squad operated inside the enclosure of a former priory about 2 kilometers outside Angers. It is known as Martyrs' Field today. The condemned persons were tied in pairs to a central rope and were marched from the prison to the place. Those who could not walk were taken in cars. Mary Ann and Odile were scheduled for execution on 1st February. Sister Odile was hit by several bullets and died immediately. Mary Ann received only a broken arm from a bullet, and she held Odile in her arms. There is nothing on record to say exactly how she was killed, but it would have been by either a sword or by a bullet. At the ceremony in Rome on 19th February 1984, Pope John Paul II beatified 99 persons who died for the faith in Angers. In it, he said that Sister Mary Ann comforted Odile by saying, "We will have the happiness of seeing God and possessing Him for all eternity, and we will be possessed by Him without fear of being ever separated from Him." The history of these 99 martyrs shows us a whole Christian people, vocations are diverse, solid and well-rooted faith. With their priests, the laity hold a great place, and especially women from all walks of life and professions. Our martyrs are calling us to a start. They show us how to behave in this world.